Have you ever seen a baby sea star? They're super tiny and pretty cute. But calling this a baby sea star isn't quite right. It's more like a teenager. Now this is a baby sea star. As is the case with many animals that start life as plankton, the babies look a world apart from the adults. For plankton, this kind of dramatic, shape-shifting metamorphosis is the norm, and it's all in the name of survival. Starting off looking a little different can provide certain advantages, like the ability to better protect yourself at a more vulnerable stage in life. Take these brittle star babies. These microscopic spaceships start life with 6 sharp spines, enough to make a predator think twice before chomping down. Knowing what an adult brittle star looks like, you'd think the spines would morph into the adult's arms, right? Wrong. None of these spines become part of the adult at all. First, the 4 shorter spines break off, giving way to raspberry-like buds that grow into arms. The 2 outer spines remain for a bit longer, both as a spiky deterrent and to act as a sort of parachute, slowing the baby brittle star's eventual descent to the bottom of the ocean. When those last spines fall off, the brittle star's life as a plankton is complete. As its former self floats away, the brittle star drops down to the sandy bottom to crawl around as a gangly, 5-armed adult. Looking and acting differently can also help baby plankton steer clear of fights with their parents. As an adult, this ribbon worm lives life on the rocks. But to avoid competition over food between adults and their young, these worms start life somewhere else, floating in the water above. Way up there, the eggs of some types of ribbon worms hatch into something we call a pelidium. Looking like a frilly hat with ear flaps, it starts the next few weeks bobbing in the currents, feeding on algae, a food source not on the menu for adults. Before sinking down to its new home on the seafloor, its next body form bursts out from within the pelidium and starts its carnivorous adulthood by eating the remains of its larval self. In the ocean, nothing goes to waste. Sometimes adults can be set in their ways, but it's healthy for kids to strike out and find their own way in life. Take these adult mussels. They're happily glued in place. To make babies and encourage them to spread their wings, mussels release sperm and eggs into the water in a process called broadcast spawning. Sent on their merry way to float with the ocean currents, the fertilized eggs hatch into a series of larval forms. Yep. Believe it or not, this creature will eventually turn into the mussel we all know and love. Its frilly elephant ears, called a vellum, help it swim. Then it turns into the appropriately named D-shaped larva. Those hairs are called cilia and help the young mussels find a new neighborhood to settle down into. Whatever the reason behind metamorphosis in plankton, these babies add to the incredible diversity of life in this microscopic world, and some cuteness to boot.